recently, January 2014. And when the holidays come around, we always begin to think about those who are not with us because they had a position. They had a position in our family. And when they were living, they did this for for the holidays. When it was time for them, for time for the holidays, everybody plays their own special roles in the family. Whether you're the person who drinks a lot, or you're the life of the party, or whether you're the person who carves the turkey, whether it's grandpa, grandma cooking all the chitlins, everybody plays a part in the family, even down to the children who play outside. And so when someone dies in our family, we miss that. We miss that at the holiday season. And so I want to encourage those of you who may be feeling down and you may not feel like getting up, doing anything for the holiday season, because maybe you just lost someone who was very special to you. Maybe it ain't been too long ago, you know, and maybe it's been years. But I want to encourage you, and I'm even encouraging myself on tonight, this morning, to get up and rejoice in the day anyway. Because I tell you, I fight to get through my holidays and I win because I trust God. Because I'm going to tell you something, you only get one life to live. And if that person that you're missing, if they was here right now, they would tell you to get up. Get out of that depressed mood, get out of that blues mood, and come on and enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself. Once our family passes on, we can't stop living. We have to live. We have to live. And it does hurt. It hurts a lot because the song that was playing earlier, Holy One by Inesha, I mean, I almost broke down up in here. I almost broke down in here, I'm telling you. So my encouragement to you is to get up and live through the holidays. Don't give up on yourself. You did nothing wrong. It's okay to cry and feel sad, but don't stay there. Enjoy your holidays with the family members that you have living. The ones that you have left now are the ones that you need to be loving on, okay? And I want to send my thoughts and prayers and condolences out to the family of Pastor Sean Jones. Very awesome gospel singer and pastor in the quartet industry. Oh, my heart and my thoughts and prayers go straight out to the family and his groups and everyone that is connected with him. I just pray for all of them. My heart, I read this article in the Christian Post, and I tell you, it just really got to my heart. When I read the song that he was singing, I want to just read y'all a little bit of what the Christian Post said about Pastor Sean Jones. Okay, 30-year-old pastor, gospel singer Sean Jones dies while singing Worthy Is He. Gospel singer and founding pastor of New Thing Empowerment Church, Sean Jones began singing with his band of believers shortly after 8 p.m. at the Event Center in Pensacola, Florida, on Saturday. Shortly after Jones began singing Worthy Is he fatally collapsed on stage, leaving his fans in shock. He was just 32 years old. They were doing a fantastic job. It was a nice show, Kenneth Woodson, manager of the Event Center, recalled to the Christian Post. Of the Sean jo Jones and the Believers Band Monday evening. Now, let me tell you, that's why I say, and he was such a great man. I mean, I'm telling y'all, when I tell y'all the last 2 months, I was watching him every Sunday. Every Sunday, Evangelist Loretta Coleman or Reverend Loretta Coleman from down in South Carolina, she would share his post because she was, you know, just like a mother to him. So she would share his live all the time at his church. And I couldn't wait for it to come on. I would get up every morning and I would wait to see what he was going to preach about this time. And I remember the last thing that that really stuck in my mind that he was preaching about. It was about 2 weeks ago. it really stuck in my mind. And I said, oh my God, God is using him today. He said, listen, I'm a real good singer. I can sing real good. But if I ain't telling you about the word of God, then I'm not telling you anything. Because singing will not get you into heaven. And those words stayed in my mind, in my heart. And I tell you, he will be missed. I'm already missing him. He will be missed. I know everyone is missing him. He touched more than the quartet world. That's why I tell y'all, don't close yourself in. Be open to what God has given you. You don't know where your assignment is, because he touched more than the quartet world. He even stepped into the R&B world. And Tweet, the R&B singer from back in the 90s, early 90s, I think it was, or late 90s, maybe 2000, something around there. But, you know, she even tweeted him out as being, you know, her little brother, like her little brother. She loved his singing. She loved his singing. So, y'all, we need to be thankful. Be thankful for Pastor Jones' life, for Pastor Sean Jones' life. So keep his wife and his children in prayer, and those that are definitely really close to him, keep them in prayer. And I'm going to send this song out, and I'm going to dedicate it to the family and all the friends in the quartet world. I mean, I just find that this song right here is so fitting for it. And I believe that if Pastor Sean Jones was living today, that he would say, good choice, good song choice. It's nothing real stompy or anything. It's just a simple little song that says, we love to praise your name. All right, y'all, you're listening to UGA Gospel Storm Midnight Love Garden with Miss Coco Bowden right here on iHeartRadio. Here is the Christian Angels.
Looking back over my life, so many heartaches, pain, and strife. There were days I thought I couldn't make it, but I realized with you, Jesus, I could take it. Lost my job, my car, and my home. But Jesus, you didn't leave me alone. Even though I could see you, Jesus, I could feel you, because I knew you were there. Sometimes I didn't have money to pay all my bills. Couldn't even tell nobody. Oh, because I was so ashamed. You dried every one of my tears, took away all my fears. But I, in the midst of it all, the enemy could take away my praise. I want to
thank you for the sunshine.
I just want to
thank you for the rain.
Not only that, my trials, in the midst of my storms, but even